Okay, let's look at our power lowering formulas, and I've recalled the double angle formula, one of the double angle formulas for cosine here. And our goal here is going to be to solve for the sine squared, and we'll get a power lowering formula. So let's, we'll have negative 2 sine squared x, and we're going to subtract the 1 from both sides. So I've got this. Now I need to divide both sides by negative 2. And typically we don't have a negative on the bottom of a fraction. We'd rather it be out to the front of the fraction or on top. So I'm going to move my negative up to the top. In a fraction, it doesn't matter if the negative is on top or the bottom, it's the same thing. And so now I'll distribute my negative. And my 1 now is positive, and my cosine of 2x now is negative. So what we have is a power lowering formula for sine. So we take, you know, some keys to this. This is a sine squared, and on the right side we have cosine to the first power. On the left side the angle is x, and on the right side the angle is double that angle. So if this were a 2x, then this would be a 4x. And that's something you'll probably see fairly often. Let's look at the power lowering formula for cosine squared of x now. Here's another version of the double angle formula for cosine, and now what we're going to do is solve this equation for cosine squared to get a power lowering formula for cosine. So the first thing I will do is add 1 to both sides. So I've got 2 cosine squared of x equals cosine of 2x. Sorry, I'm going to write it a certain way. 1 plus cosine of 2x. And now I'm going to divide both sides by 2. Okay, so we've got this formula for the power lowering formula for cosine. Again, this side is squared, this side's to the first. This angle is x, and this angle is double that. So when you lower the power, the angle doubles. Let me remind you of the power lowering formula for sine. It was very similar, but it's 1 minus cosine of 2x over 2. So the reason I put the 1 in front over here is to make it look similar to this formula. Well, now the formula for tangent is rather simple. Tangent squared of x is sine squared, which is this, divided by cosine squared, which is this, because tangent is sine over cosine. So we end up with 1 minus cosine of 2x over 2 all over 1 plus the cosine of 2x over 2. And when you get something divided by 2, divided by something divided by 2, the 2's will drop out and leave 1's. So tangent squared of x, when you reduce the power of that, you end up with 1 minus cosine of 2x over 1 plus cosine of 2x. So there are our 3 power lowering formulas. Notice that all 3 of them, when you reduce the power on a cosine, you get a cosine. When you reduce the power on a sine, you get a cosine. And when you reduce the power on tangent, you get cosines. Okay? And also notice that in all of them, if the angle here is x, the angle here is double that. Right? So when you reduce the powers on all 3 of these, the angles double.